again. Today I'm doing my next episode on seagulls. I'm here at Frost Point, and as you can see, there's one just out there on those rocks. Now, despite the name, they're not really called seagulls. They're really just gulls, because they don't really live out on the sea. And that one right there is a mature adult. The ones that are either black and white or gray and white are the mature adults, and the ones that are brown are immature juveniles. And seagulls are scavengers, and they'll sometimes compete with crows over food.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Haven't really seen many seagulls. It's probably because they tend to avoid humans. But I do know some things about their larger cousins, the albatross. The albatross, they've got the biggest and widest wingspans of any animal in the world. The largest was 13 feet wide, but there have been some rumors of wingspans reaching 20 feet wide. I'm not sure if that's true or not, but if it is, then that would be pretty amazing to see. And there's another animal with a 13-foot wingspan, the marabou stork in Africa. There's two other cousins of the seagull and the albatross. They're both carnivorous, petrel and the skua. Petrels and skuas eat penguins. They live alongside penguins. Everywhere there are penguins, there are petrels and skuas. But amazingly, they're actually closely related to penguins, though. The only difference, though, there was a split in the evolutionary family tree. Penguins went one way and became flightless and evolved to swim in the ocean, and petrels and skuas went another, and they evolved to fly in the air. Another cousin of the seagull are terns, and the Arctic tern is the most extreme athlete in the world. The reason why is because it has the longest migration route of any animal in the world. They'll migrate 30,000 miles from Sweden all the way down to Antarctica in the winter. And then they migrate back again, of course, in the spring. And so that means in 1 year they would have gone 60,000 miles. They can make that same journey every year for 30 years. So in total, they would have traveled 1.8 million miles. That would be like flying from Earth to the moon and back. Seagulls are ground nesting birds. They lay their eggs on the ground, and their eggs are actually the same color as the rocks to camouflage them, to hide them from predators. And the newborn chicks are also the same color as the rocks to also hide from predators. Some predators of the seagulls are like brown bears. They'll sometimes eat chicks and eggs. And seagulls live in groups, and I assume that like most birds, they pair for life. And they have to take turns sitting on the egg. Seagulls also have complex language, and what's interesting is they'll sometimes peck whales. They're like virtually eating the whales without actually killing them. They'll just peck off little pieces. They're like parasitic birds. That can be kind of annoying to the whales, though, and it can probably hurt, which is why the birds might have to be careful, because the whales might sometimes swack their tails out at them. Now I'm here on Jeunesse Beach. There's lots more seagulls here than there were near Frost Point. Now, I think I've said that seagulls are scavengers, and if you look right there behind me, there's a seagull that's got an Oreo cookie in its mouth. Obviously, some kid might have thrown it to it. Seagulls will eat or anything. They're scavengers and they're omnivores. They eat both plants and meat. Spot on the beach, there are these pipes that lead to the swamp. When those things are opened up at low tide, there's lots of seagulls here, and I know that because when I was a kid, I used to love chasing them around. I saw them here a lot when I went for walks here. Seagulls sometimes compete with crows. They fight over food sometimes. You see, Some seagulls live inland where crows live, and sometimes crows will come down to the beach. I have seen them together, and they do compete over food sometimes. And seagulls and crows actually kind of make the same sound, it's just that a seagull sounds kind of different. Back in the time of the dinosaurs, in the late Cretaceous period, about 8 million years ago, there was a prehistoric seagull called Ichthyornis, and it had teeth. And 30 million years ago in South America, 35 million years after the dinosaurs went extinct, there was a huge ancestor of seagulls and albatrosses called Pelagornis. It had a wingspan 30 feet wide, it was 6 feet long, and weighed 90 pounds. And what's interesting is, unlike modern-day seagulls and albatrosses, Pelagornis and Ichthyornis, they, like I said, they both have teeth.
Thanks for watching. See you again next time on Ben's Wild Adventure.